today we are working on a Samsung dryer. It just kind of hums when they turn it on. There's no, it doesn't tumble. It sounds like the motor is bound up. So we're not sure what is making it be bound up. So we're gonna just tear into it and see what's going on. Okay, so on this dryer, there are just some clips that are here and here. We just need to take a putty knife and just kind of pry this open like that. Okay, now this top can just be tilted back. So there's three screws here, here, and here, and we're just gonna undo them. I actually already undid that one, so we're gonna just move along. Okay. Now there are actually screws underneath going this way. So you need a little stubby screwdriver and to be able to tilt your dryer back so that you can access it. And there's four of them here, one on each corner and then like here and here. Now we've got two screws here and here. We have like
bend those off the frame. Yep.
Okay, now we have our lid switch right here. You're gonna undo that. Before you get too far away. Undo these four.
Can you see it?
Is this the either wheel?
Yes.
I just gotta figure out which way to...
Yeah.
I don't, I can't. Where's my motor pulley?
There.
Back here. Okay.
There you go.
Hey.
And that's how you do that.
Yep. That's pretty seized. That should spin freely.
What about your rollers?
And that one's pretty seized. And that one's pretty seized. Okay, so on this dryer, the first thing we want to do is just take off these little rings. So I just take a pair of snips and I snip and I take it off and then I remove the drum. And then you can just take a paper towel and clean up that shaft really, really good and make sure that it's not damaged in any way. So Samsung only sells this roller assembly with the roller and the shaft. However, you rarely need to replace the entire shaft, only if your shaft is damaged, has a flat spot or some digs in it. This shaft is actually in really good condition. If you have to replace this shaft, this whole back piece of your dryer has to come off so that you can access, there's bolts on the other side of this. This particular one, I'm gonna take off that roller and make sure, but as long as the shafts are okay, I'm actually just gonna remove the clip from here, put the new roller on, and go from there. Okay, so we'll just slide the new rollers on and then put on the new clips. And they spin super nice. So just a Phillips screwdriver, and we are undoing this screw. Just keep that spring in place, and then we'll change this out. Now we just need to hook that spring back up. Okay, we're gonna put the front bulkhead back on. Just kind of tilt your drum up, get those wheels underneath the drum. And then we just need to line up those hooks in the housing. Good.
Okay.
They do have little pegs that we need to make sure of. And then we have 1, 2, 3, and then 1 and 1, 2.